In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, amen. A few weeks ago, during the Lent, we read nearly the same gospel, the gospel of the temptation of our Lord Jesus Christ. But our church fathers found out that it's very essential to hear it once more at this time. Why? Let me first take the first instance why we read it a few weeks ago and why we are reading it once more today. A few weeks ago, the Lord himself was showing us he is going to start his mission. So the first thing he did, he got baptized, received the Holy Spirit, and then he went for 40 days fasting, and in the end he was tempted and he was victorious. And we believe that the church pray, that the church also believes that we are not only following the footsteps of our Lord Jesus Christ, but we are gaining what he has done for our sake. So he took flesh like us all, except sin, as we know. And then he was telling us for the first time since the fall of Adam, I received the Holy Spirit in this corruptible body. And then he went to the temptation and he was victorious. To tell us, I am the victory himself. He is the author of every victory. But why you have been tempted and you have received this victory? He was telling us it is for your sake. I took your fallen nature, I received the Holy Spirit, or I enabled this body to receive the Holy Spirit for the first time, and from now on, you will be able to be victorious in your temptation. This was has been done in the life of our Lord for our sake, as we prayed in the Creed many times, who for us and for our salvation became man. And inclusively, he was tempted and victorious. Inclusively, he was transfigured. Every single thing in his life was who for me and for my salvation became man and did everything. So why are we reading it once more now? Last week, the church celebrated the Feast of the Pentecost. The church now started to enjoy what Jesus did. Yes, he received the Holy Spirit in his body for our sake, but till this moment, when he received it, we received nothing in person. So on the day of Pentecost, the church started to enjoy what Jesus enabled for our human nature. So on the day of Pentecost, everyone in the church at the time, those who repented, those who believed, those who got baptized, received the gift of the Holy Spirit. And he is telling us, what I have done it for you, that you need to go through the same path to be victorious. So now we are sent into the world, but differently. After receiving the power of the Holy Spirit, we're going through many temptations and trials, but the victory is assured in our Lord Jesus Christ. So we read this today because last week we received the Holy Spirit and he is telling us, I am with you to assure your victory, to be with you step by step in each and every temptation. But now you are not thinking, am I going to be victorious or not? I'm going to proclaim the victory that Jesus has done and put in my account. It's very important, my mindset when I am going through such temptation. Am I going there to be defeated? Am I going there to withdraw from the victory that Jesus has done and the victory that Jesus has won and put it in my own account? A very famous quote of St. Augustine. He was telling us, when Jesus was in the flesh, the church was hidden. What does it mean? When Jesus was in the flesh, the church did not appear yet. So the church was hidden in his body. That's why St. Paul was telling us in Ephesians chapter 1 that we are his body. But he did everything for the body, not for himself. So when the church was hidden in him, he did everything for the sake of the church. His victory was for the church. His cross and death was for the church. His resurrection and the power of resurrection was for the church. So once the church appeared in the day of the Pentecost, born in the day of Pentecost, the church started to enjoy what Jesus did and put in her account. So now we are the victorious church in our temptation because what Jesus did. We are the risen church because what Jesus did, he rose and he raised his body with him. That's why St. Paul is telling us in Romans chapter 8 and verse 11, if the Spirit who raised Jesus Christ dwells in you. And again, let us not imagine, but assure ourselves, if the Spirit who raised Jesus Christ from death dwells in you, what is going to happen. Every single thing Jesus did now is conveyed to you by grace through adoption. What does it mean? The Lord was telling us in John chapter 16 and verse 14, He will glorify me. He will take what is mine and declare it to you, convey it to you. As if He's telling you, whenever you come before the Lord, whether you are praying a liturgy, attending a Bible study, praying in your room, it's time to enjoy the work of the Holy Spirit in your life. He is conveying today victory in your temptation. He is conveying healing in your sickness. He is conveying transfiguration in your darkness. He is conveying light in your darkness, and so on. He is telling us every single time you are in the presence of the Lord, the Holy Spirit is doing a personal miracle in your life. What are you looking for this morning in this liturgy? If He's telling us it's a world of temptation, the Lord is telling us it's a world of victory, because I have assured this victory for you. If you are coming to this liturgy this morning fully defeated from whatever sin it is, He's telling you it's time to ask the Holy Spirit to convey my victory in your life, to enjoy the fullness of this victory. Maybe you have been for many years in this defeat, in these doubts, in this confusion. But He is telling me and you again this morning, I am able to make a new start. He's telling us in Revelation chapter 21, verse 5, He is awakening every heart. I'm going to do something new, and in your life, and in your life personally. We praise this liturgy that the Lord will enlighten our minds to see that the victory He has done, the victory He has won it for me and for you, to enjoy the conveyance of this victory through the work of the Holy Spirit in the life of each and every one of us. May the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you from now and forever and ever.